Welcome back. And we are going to do some video editing on YouTube. YouTube has all these tools on the back end. So if you don't have access to video editing software, you can actually use a lot of these to make your video look a lot more professional. Now here, I just clicked on edit here in my video manager. And of course it pulls up my video here. And there's a few different options. You can see I've got an auto fix. Auto anything doesn't ever work quite as well as we would like it to. Now, if you ever make a mistake, you don't like the way it is, just make sure you click here, revert to original. It'll take you back to the way your video was before. So some of the things we can do here is we can stabilize a video. It helps remove shaky camera movement, but stabilizing features, they really don't make up for a very shaky video. You can use this to help take away a little bit of shake, but really your best bet is to be using a tripod whenever possible. And here I can add fill light, which you see makes a video much brighter. And whenever I move one of these sliders over, I have to wait a couple seconds for YouTube to process it. And then I'll see an example of the original and what it would look like with that change. So one of the other things that's good is I can up the contrast. This is good if you're in a situation where the background and the foreground are very similar colors, just to make things stand out a little more. Saturation increases your color saturation. So if you take that down, it'll turn your video black and white. If you take it up, it makes your video super, super bright, almost cartoonish. And then color temperature, we can go down to cooler colors, to blue. And this is really good. If you filmed in a room that had like the yellowish light bulbs, you can help take that yellow tint out. The opposite end, making your video warmer, that can be good if you film somewhere and the video just feels cold or not personable. Adding a little bit of warmth helps. Of course, here we can also add a little bit of slow motion. They only go 8x slow motion, which isn't super, super slow-mo. And the way YouTube does it is, of course, they can't insert frames they don't have. They just space out your frames a little more. So you can use it for a little bit of effect, but it's not really true slow motion. Now here I can go ahead and trim a video. And basically, if I have a video where I had too much intro or too much outro, or I want to cut bits out, that's where you would go to for the trimming. Some of the fun things, just like Instagram, I've got filters that I can add to my video to add some artistic flair. And then there's special effects. The special effects is basically blurring faces. Don't rely on it to keep people's privacy, because it doesn't always track every face. But if you caught like video of an accident or something and you need to protect people's privacy, that is what you would use there. So when you're done, I recommend you save it as a new video instead of pressing save. That way you always have access to your original.